Hello, welcome to Iggy's Toy Parade and Soldier Review. And now, here is your host, Iggy.
Yay.
Thank you for that. Hi, guys. Welcome back. I'm going to do another episode of guidebooks for you. And this time, we're going to be focusing on G.I. Joe. Now, the first book I ever bought for collecting G.I. Joe was this book here, Collectible Male Action Figures. And I think I bought this book in 1990. Let's see here. 1990, yes. And actually, I didn't buy it. My wife bought it for me. And I wonder what she thought. She's probably, oh my God, I'm married to a 10-year-old. But she didn't stay married to me, so I guess it's okay. What am I mumbling about? Anyway, let's take a look at it. There's no need for me to mumble. And I remember being so excited when I was looking through this book because I hadn't seen many of the things in this book in years. And it just was a joy to see everything in their original packaging and just the way I remembered everything. It just was very exciting and thrilling to see everything once more. I had that one when I was a kid. My mom tried to get me all the sort of non-violent ones, like this one here is the MP. I had that, and I had this one up here. I think I had the Shore Patrol guy. I had the medic. You know, anything with a rifle in it, and she wouldn't buy it. My grandma bought this for me. I still have it. But anyway, this book I was very excited to get and loved all the illustrations in it. And it sort of rekindled my interest in G.I. Joe, which had been dormant for many years because I had been collecting Star Wars figures. And it covers Adventure Team also. And for some strange reason, I think the author's wife insisted on this. Oh, by the way, I wanted this when I was a kid so bad. And the kids across the street had it. And I wanted that. Except instead of Germans, they had Japanese guys. Man, did I ever want that. Of course, that never happened. They put Ken. What's Ken doing in here? Are you serious? Compare these guys to a G.I. Joe? Oh my God. How did this happen? At any rate, that was the first book that I got, which let's see if we can give you a good view of it. I'm having difficulty seeing because my glasses are steamed up. The air conditioning where I live is broken, and it's very steamy in here now. And my shirt is wet, and I just got out of the shower. This book by Vincent Santelmo is very complete, very good. I would recommend this to you if you're serious about Joe's. I marked some pages. Do you guys remember getting these kinds of things when you were kids? I remember I got this because it didn't have a gun. Or was it this? I can't remember now. But whatever it wasn't that, that's for sure. They used to make German helmets, and the Marx used to make German helmets and hand grenades and everything. I had a German helmet and an MP40 squirt gun. And my brother must have gotten that for him because mom would have never done that. And I remember when I was 8 years old going to the mall, marching around with my German helmet and my MP40. And I just thought I was the coolest kid. Nowadays, I'd probably get arrested or something, or my dad would have been arrested. I wasn't with mom on that trip. Anyway, this is very complete. It does have color pages in it too. I marked them. Why did I mark this page? Oh, because I really like the Soldiers of the World. I never had those as a kid, but now I've got an Australian, a German, and a Japanese. So I only have three more to go. There's color pages in here too. Don't see them. It's way back here. Here you go. I'm mumbling again. Sorry, guys. Yeah, see, it's got color pages in here. I had this as a boy. I think they released that because of Thunderball. I had the space capsule as a boy. Here's the prototype. I like this spacesuit better than this one, but that was what they originally came up with. Oh, look, here's the Soldiers of the World. I bought, I think, four of these at Target when they went on clearance for $3.98. I think I'd like to have this French guy and the British guy. Well, the ones I'm missing are the British guy, the Russian, and the French. Anyway, this is a very detailed look at G.I. Joe, and I recommend this to you. This is also by Vincent Tantelmo, and it's also very complete. And, why is the light going in and out? Is that, I guess it needs to be turned on. How's that? You'll notice that the Stahlhelm is looks to be a pattern 1916 instead of one of the later ones. Anyway, this book is also very good and very complete. Even down to all the different uniform decals or stickers and paperwork that came with Joe, the manuals, everything. This book has what the boxes look like, everything. It was very good. So I recommend this one to you also. Then this one came with the Masterpiece Edition. So it came with a Joe and also a book, and it was unique in that if you bought a Marine, then the cover of the book would, it was the same book regardless of which one you bought, but it would ref the cover would reflect the branch of service, such as this one's Army, so he has the Army uniform. And I remember when Joe Levine died, I cut this out of the paper. This was in 2014. That's him in the background there. Why is it going on and off like that? Something weird. Anyway, I think I marked the page that shows Merrill Hassenfeld. He's one of the Hasbro brothers. Hasbro being a what would you call it? A conjunction of Hasbro brothers? I don't know how you say that. Anyway, there he is there. You'll notice he's got a cigar because that was a ubiquitous feature of executives back in those days. And I remember when my dad passed away, I found several really nice lighters, cigarette lighters. And I asked I said, Mom, Dad didn't smoke. Why did he have these lighters? And she said, well, years ago, the executives had to follow the boss around with a, and when he took out a cigar, they all had to light their lighters, and then he would, whoever he favored that day would get to light his cigar. And I thought, isn't that weird? That's something that's not part of corporate life anymore. Like the martini lunch. My dad didn't drink, so he would get a martini and just, pretend to sip at it, but he didn't drink. But just one of the weird things that they were required to do back in the day. I noticed something weird about this book, and once I saw it, I couldn't unsee it. I read this book. I really enjoyed it. It's very complete, richly illustrated, and the text is very good. And it has a lot of background things like, the modeling for the artwork. What was the artist's name? Sam Petrucci or something? But I saw something just recently, actually, when I was looking through this, and once I saw it, it kind of bothered me. But what is this? It says, well, we want to show you the knee joints. What? Okay. I'm not sure what this is. This is weird to me. Okay, something a little off about this choice of illustrations to show the knee joint. It's like a guy in prison or something. And then there's another one that really sealed the fate on this book. Not the fate, but that there's subliminal messaging going on. Okay, what is this? I don't think I need to say anything about this. You guys probably can see what I'm seeing. What the hell's going on here? And then I saw this. Do you see it? Okay. I won't say anything more about it because I don't want to get in trouble. But anyway, these are just some of the books that I have that I reference when I do a G.I. Joe video, which I haven't done for a while. This book here was given to me by some friends for Christmas, I think in 2000. Did I write it down? Yeah, no, 1999. And, I used to have a couple of these. I don't have them anymore. I used to have four of these guys. I think I still have two, but I'm not sure. Well, here's the Masterpiece Edition I was talking about. I have one of these. I have these. Well, I sold a couple of them, but I think I still have a couple left. I had this one, but I sold it. I didn't get very much for it, like 15 bucks or something. Here's the Green Berets. I had that when I was a kid. Dad got it for me. I got this one over here with the bazooka. Anyway, this book is by, I think, DePriest. DePriest, yes. Daryl DePriest. He's sort of a famous Joe guy, too. So this one was written by Joe Levine and a guy named John Mischlig, and he was a fan of G.I. Joe. And so, in fact, there's pictures of him at Christmas time with G.I. Joe. Now, when I was a kid, I felt a special affinity to Joe because I also had a scar on my face, except mine went from the corner of my mouth towards my ear that way. And I got it. There was a boy lived a couple doors down. We found a razor blade on the, in the driveway, and we both reached for it at the same time. And then he got it, and we started fighting over. So I saw it first, and he said, "Well, you want it? You can have it." And he sliced my face open, and it was cut open like a steak. And I was wearing a white T-shirt that was completely red by the time I got home, which was two doors over. And I remember when my mom saw me, she was horrified, and I didn't cry until I saw my mom's reaction, because then I knew I was in trouble. But I was holding my face together with my hand. You can't see the scar now because I was like 5 years old when I got it, so it's just vaguely visible. Anyway, these are the G.I. Joe books, and I'm sorry to do this so quickly and perfunctory. But it's really hot in here, guys. I want to get out of here and sit in my car with the air conditioning because it's just too hot. You know it's hot when you sit on your toilet and when you get up, the toilet seat sticks to your butt and then it slips off and slams on the toilet bowl rim. That's when you know it's hot. And my arm sticks to the paper, and it's just awful. Anyway, and for some reason, my camera keeps going on and off, on and off. I don't know what's going on, guys. Anyway, thanks for getting Iggy with it. Next time, I'll share some. This will be the last one on reference books, is this one up here. And thanks for getting Iggy with it, you guys. I'm sorry I don't have something more thrilling to show you. But I think I showed you everything. There might be a couple boxes that were buried pretty deep that I didn't get to, but we'll see. Anyway, you guys stay cool. I don't know what temperature is in here, but it's got to be 100 inside here. It's pretty bad. So I'm going to get out of here. And I wish you guys the best and keep collecting. Take those things out of your basement or attic or wherever it is you have them hidden away. You'll be surprised how much you still enjoy them. All right, guys, take care. I'll talk to you next time.